A lot of support out there. What do you make of all that?
Just people recognise the real in me. They know that this is the dad until you get 100%. What you see is what you get. So people can adapt to that in life, in and outside the octagon. So I believe I have fans everywhere. I didn't think I had this many fans, but it's overwhelming. It's good for me. It touches me right here.
Well, no, this is a tough time for you. I mean, you know the question everybody wants to know. What's the, do we get a number? What's the weight at right now?
182 this morning. So we'll see. Friday, I'm not stepping on any heavier than 170. Hopefully under, you know, then I can have my traditional coke, what I'm used to having. So we'll see, but I'm not looking ahead of anything now. I'm not thinking about tomorrow. I'm not thinking about Friday. I'm thinking about today, open workouts. I'm going to go and eat now. I'm going to go and train later. And, you know, I've put my life into this. So speed bumps along the way, you know, not making weight. You get all this attention for it. It's like you're the only fighter who's ever missed weight in the division, in the whole of the UFC. It's not true, but it's a mistake on my part. And Friday, all the talk will be done. No motherfucker can ask me a question about weight again. He's getting slapped.
Where does 182 rank? Like a normal Wednesday, a normal fight week, is that normal, light, heavy? What is it?
That's the same as I was for me fight before Steven. So I fought against Cowboy. I was about 182 on the Wednesday. And I had a great cut for that. You know, I'm never going to say it's a great cut. It's always hard. But listen, I'm lean. I'm focused. Weight's okay. I never want to stand here and say weight's great, this has been the best weight cut, because the fighters do that and I just don't agree with it. It's just a lie. Weight's not great. I don't want to speak to anyone. I don't want to, you know, I just want to get me things done. It's business. Business is business. And Saturday is business. Friday's business. My life is this business.
We saw you last week and you admitted you were having a bad day. How many bad days have you had since then?
Just that one. We all have them, you know, whether you're a fighter or not. You gotta get on. I was just having one of them days, you know. I was just sick of the train. I was sick of everything. I'm just, you know, I'm in my moment now where I just want to fight. I live for this. I'm just ready to fight. I'm not ready for anything else. I'm not ready I don't think about anything. I don't really care about anything. I just want Saturday to come as quick as possible for me to show why I'm one of the best fighters alive. I say it time and time again, and I'll continue to prove it against the best. Tyron Woodley is, in my opinion, one of the best welterweights of all time. And I will prove that I will beat him and be one of the best myself.
Last thing for me, I mean, you've been under a microscope, no question about it, man. All this media, all this tension, you said all the questions. What's it like? I mean, you're on the cusp of greatness. I mean, are you enjoying this? Are you hating this? What's the emotion like right now?
It's what comes with it. It doesn't matter if I like it or hate it. I do enjoy it. I enjoy speaking my mind. I enjoy people finding out who the real Darren Till is. A lot of fighters stand behind you and you don't know who the real fighter is. They're that real person. They're either scripted or they're just the same, some bullshit that they think people want to hear. I don't say anything that I think people want to hear. I say what I mean and I mean what I say. Everything that comes out of my mouth is 100% legit. So whether I like it or not, doesn't matter. Some days I love it. Like right now, I love this. I love the attention there, the open workouts. That day you see me, I just want to slap everyone inside. So it's mixed days, but as you say, sometimes people don't want to go into work and do their job and they have to. So that, this is my job. It doesn't matter. I can't be a little drama bitch over it. Just get it done.
You said there's a sense of relief in Tyron Nance to it, but you were so cooped up in Las Vegas and so frustrated being there. Now is there a sense of relief being in Dallas? You're here, the crowds.
Yeah, I've got my own hotel room, so I'm alone. I can hide from everyone. So if anyone comes knocking, I can hide in the bathroom, pretend I'm not there. So yeah, I'm on my own a bit. It's just, we were there for 3 weeks in Vegas, and it wasn't like I was in the gym and then I leave the gym, you know, back in Liverpool, and I go off and do my own thing. It was constant. It was 24 hours. It was, as you say, microscope on Darren Till. Is you training? Are you recovering? Are you eating? Are you drinking your water? And that all needs to be done. But sometimes, you know, you have them days where you feel suffocated, and I just felt, you know, suffocated sometimes. But couldn't have got any better. It was great just being in Vegas with my team. You know, my girlfriend, my coach, we were all under one roof. We were all together all the time, eating together. It was good vibes, man. It was good energy. It was great energy. I'm a happy guy that I went to Vegas for 3 weeks.
Darren, look, lots has been said about if, for whatever reason, you didn't make weight, that Usman would be the one to fight Woodley, which he's not willing to do, it sounds like. What about if it's the other way around and for whatever reason? Would you fight him?
I don't care. Usman was put in not because of me. He was put in the fight because maybe Woodley had turned out the fight. There's no way I've got plenty of injuries right now. There's no way you're never going to see me not fight. No way. There's for the Cowboy fight, I tore my knee in half. I begged my coach for 3 days. I said, I am not pulling out of this fight no matter what. Put that shit to the back of your head. So it wasn't because of me. Let me assure you of that. the only thing is weight. It wasn't because of me. And yeah, if Woodley doesn't fight Saturday, Usman can get it. Anyone can get it from any category, welterweight, middleweight. It doesn't even matter if it's for the belt. As long as I fight Saturday, that's all that matters.
And how do you feel up there on the stage, putting on the show for the fans?
Just energy, just showcasing my skills. I've worked on this for years. I've worked to be, in my mind, fighting's about being the greatest technician. It's not about who's the strongest or who can give the hardest punch. It's all about technical ability. And I feel like I'm one of the best technical fighters in the world. And I showcase that to the fans, I showcase it to the media. Just an honour. I get paid for doing this as well. You know, I don't have to, it's amazing. I don't worry about anything. I love going to the gym. A bonus on that is I'm recognised worldwide and I get paid for that shit. It's phenomenal. I can't even put it into words. It does touch home sometimes and I have to sit back and smell the roses.
Darren, just to clarify, I think you're gonna make some people nervous. You said you're carrying some injuries. I mean, are we talking about more than outside of the normal bumps and bruises? Are you
just
dealing with
issues? Just the same old shit, broken bones here, there, broken hands. Just same old shit, what every fighter I'm sure has, but hasn't got the fucking bollocks to talk about. Or, do you know what I mean? As I said, what you see is what you get with me. Every fighter goes into a fight 90%, 80%. He doesn't go in 100%. And if he does, he hasn't fucking trained right. I train my bollocks off. Every day I'm punching people hard, my hands are hurting. You know, us as fighters, we carry injuries. No, there's nothing. Unless I trip now on a wire and break my leg. Nothing's keeping me out of that fight. Nothing ever will. And if I go into that fight with an injury, I won't speak about it. And if I lose that fight because of an injury, I won't speak about it after. Because when you go into a fight, you go in knowing you can win. If you come out after that fight saying, I didn't win because of this, you went in that fight not knowing you could have won, so why did you fucking go in that fight? I go in knowing I can win with injury or without injury. So just the same niggles. Darren Till's there, Saturday, I can't wait.
Darren, just lastly, you're in Dallas now, but can you feel the support
from
back home?
Are you sure?
Can you feel the support from back home?
Yeah, just every day I'm trying to keep up. I only have one particular social media on my phone, it's Instagram. I can't keep Twitter. I can't keep all that other because it'd probably take over my life. As I've spoken, I don't like really the internet world taking over my life, you know, sitting there scrolling, seeing what people are saying. You know, on my Instagram, I post a photo, you know, I reply to a few comments and then I get off. I try to reply as many messages as possible, but it just gets to a point where you can't, and then people say, well, why haven't you got someone working for you? Because then it wouldn't be Dad Until replying, would it? It'd be some other cunt. So no one will ever work for me. It's my Instagram, it's my social media, and that's just how it's always going to be. I don't care if I get 30 million followers and there's 30 million messages a day. I'll try and reply. Is it possible to reply? No, but I'll try. It'll be Dad Until replying, it won't be someone else. So the support's amazing.
All right, thanks,
thanks,
Darren.
Thank you, guys.
Let's go, Darren!